Alright, so we are making a mister system or a drip irrigation spray system for a greenhouse, or I've also used it for a nursery, a tree nursery, so small potted plants, cuttings, anything that you're trying to propagate, as well as trees that you want to grow out into bigger trees. A lot of this also applies to larger scale drip irrigation systems. These are the main components that you're going to need to establish what I call the main line or the supply line. So you've got your simple on-off switch valve. Turn this to stop the flow of water. Turn that to turn it on so you can divide your system into sections with these. You've got your elbows for when you need to turn a tight 90 degree corner. You've got your T's and you've got your menders. And then this is what you use to end a run of half inch tubing. Just do that by folding it over, and that just holds it in place so it creates a kink which stops the water there. And when you're using these are called slide lock, and I get them from dripworks.com, and you just work that on there, and you have to kind of wiggle it back and forth so that the ribs on here will actually pull that half inch tubing forward. As you press and wiggle, those pull it forward. This part has to be twisted all the way back, and then once you have your tubing as far on as you can, you then twist this forward, and that locks it into place. And it's so tight that I can't pull it off no matter how hard I try. These are super cheap, and half inch tubing is super cheap. You can get it in 500 foot rolls at Home Depot for about $50, so it's like a penny a foot. It's extremely inexpensive. I've put together a ton of irrigation systems with just these parts. The only part that I didn't talk about are the actual emitters. I've got a couple different kinds here. This is a mister emitter, and so the water sprays out here in a very fine mist. Up a little further down, you can see this red one. This is more of a spray style emitter, so this is gonna emit more water in a spray. And then this is a drip emitter here, and so that's just going to have water dripping straight down. And I'll show you how easy it is to pull these in and out. There you go, you put it out, and then I don't have the part with me right at the second, but that's how fast it is to pop those in and out. There's a little tool that you can use, just a couple different styles, but you can also in a pinch just use a piece of wire or anything sharp. If you're using a knife, you have to be careful not to make that hole too big, because you want it to be big enough for this to push through, but not so big that this won't catch when there's water pressure on it. So that little piece right there needs to catch on your tubing.
We just have a simple regular faucet, and we have a $50 timer from Home Depot with AA batteries. And right now it's set to run for 3 minutes every 8 hours, so it's running 4 times a day. It keeps this greenhouse watered just fine. And I'm gonna set it to run manually, and we are probably gonna get wet. It takes a minute to kick on. There you go, you hear the valve releasing, and the pressure is building. And you can see the difference between this guy, which is doing more of a fine spray, so that's the mister, and then we have the sprayer in red over there, which sprays more volume of water, and it sprays it a little bit further. So I prefer the sprayers for larger plants, like in a tree nursery, and I prefer the misters for smaller flats, like when you're doing cuttings or starting seeds or something like that. This whole greenhouse system probably costs under $150. It could be set up in less than a day by one person, probably just a couple hours, honestly. The only other variable is your water pressure. Depending on how much water pressure you have, most regular home water systems have 50 to 60 psi. I actually have a pressure reducer, so this brings the psi down to 30. And if I were to expand that system, like make it twice as big, I would take this off. There would be a limit to how big I could make this system before I would have to start dividing it up into zones and having multiple timers. I could easily double the size of this system and then add 3 more timers, so I could have 8 times the amount of irrigation on this one spigot, and I would just set these timers to run at slightly different intervals so that they were never running at the same time, so that I could use that pressure that I have available to me to water as much stuff as possible. We've got blackberries, ginger, turmeric, got pollinators in here, so we see the bees and the bumblebees flying in, some elderberries growing here, some aloe, the morning glory vines, the peach tree,
and even the rosemary want to be in the greenhouse. They're starting to invade into the greenhouse. But one of the benefits of this greenhouse and the mister system specifically is the evaporative cooling. Every time that we run this mister system in the day, it puts all this water out here on the ground, and then as that water evaporates, it cools the temperature in the greenhouse. It hasn't been that hot this summer, so we haven't had the fans running, but then if you also get some airflow from side to side, it stays really cool in here, and it actually helps to keep this structure cool that the greenhouse is attached to. And we've just got a few skylights up here. Every other little opening here has a skylight, and that's enough light to keep all these plants growing, as well as the front and side faces being glass.